All right, so we've got the overall shape of our site elevation drawn. And now what we're gonna do is we're gonna figure out where to place the windows and the doors. So to do this, so far I haven't needed my floor plan. I was just drawing the outside shape following the directions in the book. But now I do need my floor plan. I need to figure out where the windows and the doors are located. I want to make sure that they're very specifically projected from the right place. So what I'm going to do is, this is a little tricky. This is, there's several ways that you could go about this. This is just one of the ways that we can do it. What I'm going to do is I'm going to take a copy of my floor plan. I'm going to rotate it and move it up here so that I can project all of those features down. Before I do that, when I make that copy, I'm going to show you guys, this is a cool little trick here. I don't need all these layers. That's going to confuse me. Like, there's so much going on with that floor plan. Really, all I need are my walls, windows, and doors. That's all I'm really concerned with. But check this out. So you know that you can come in here, and if I don't want to see my dimensions, I can just turn off my dimensions, and that would be an easy way to do that. I want to show you something cool. Look, this little off button right here. If I just select that, and I click on a dimension, as long as it's not my current layer right now, the whole layer just turns off. So I can turn off, I don't even need to know the name of it. I can just click here, don't wanna see that. Click here, I don't need my plumbing. I don't need my bedroom. I don't need my electrical. I don't need this. I really just want windows and doors. So, yep, you can just come in here and just kind of turn off what you don't need. You don't have to do that step. I'm just showing you something cool that you can do in AutoCAD. Now that we've got this, I'm going to do the copy command. I'll copy and I'll just grab all of this. Select the objects, press enter. It wants a base point. We'll just kind of click wherever for that base point. And then I'm going to move it up and over here. I'm gonna use the rotate command and I'm gonna rotate this, select. You know what I could do is, rotate. I'm gonna select this object anywhere for a base point. It doesn't really matter, but what we need to do is we need to rotate it down this way. So you could type in 270 degrees. You could type in negative 90 degrees. You could visually do it the way that I am. That's especially good if you have ortho or polar turned on. So that looks good. What we need to do now is make sure that our walls actually line up here. So let's go, I'm just gonna go set some other layer current. And let's draw a construction line. V for vertical. And let's just draw a construction line right where this wall is. And that way we know that this wall over here needs to line up right there. So we're gonna move it into place. Select here and just make sure it touches. If you wanna do shift right click, you can do nearest, just so that it definitely touches that wall, but it could be anywhere along that wall, honestly. Okay, so that looks good. We're gonna go back to that same, you could set a construction layer current if you have one. Let's see, I don't really have a construction layer, but let's do it, why not? It's always good to put things on the right layer. So let's, construction. I always like to make my construction layer yellow. I have just, to me, that's what construction lines look like. Be any color because ultimately you're going to turn them off. So let's go put that one on construction and then let's just go ahead and draw vertical construction lines. We want to make sure this wall lines up with that wall, which it does if we drew it correctly. But what we need now is just where are we going to place those doors and the windows. And so what I'm going to do is snap from the middle of that window. So the midpoint, which is actually the endpoint of that vertical line, but make sure you're getting right at the middle of that window. And then we're gonna grab the middle of the door. If you had drawn a line that was the size of that door, the 2'8", you could snap to the midpoint of that line. To be extra sure though, you can do your shift right click. Remember our fancy little O-snap. Shift right click is a temporary O-snap. We're gonna grab mid between two points and we'll click the edge of the door, click the edge of the door, and it just put my construction line right there at the middle. So that's good. This is where we have two windows and a door. Now doors, the standard height for residential door is 6'8". If you were to go to Lowe's and buy a door, It's going to be a 6'8" tall door. Windows vary in their height. So when we look over here at the window, remember we talked about this is a 3'0" wide window, 4'0" tall, not 30 inches wide or 40 inches tall. 3'0" wide, 4'0" tall. 2'0" wide, 2'6" tall. So we've got a 2'6" door and we've got a 2'6" window height, and we've got a 40-inch window height. But one thing that we tend to do, if you were to look at your house, you probably would notice, the front of your house, your front door and your front windows probably line up with each other at the top. That's a pretty standard thing to do, is to make them all the same height at the top, and then the windows come down from there, whatever height they happen to be. So what I'm going to do is do an offset, 6'8" for the door size. Click the floor, not the bottom of the foundation, just the floor. But this is going to be the top of my windows, the top of that door. Now that's the window and door itself, not including the trim around it. All right, so now we're going to come back over here to the elevations layer. And we made blocks. Remember in our cabin symbols drawing, you made a bunch of blocks. You made a block for these doors and windows. So we're just going to go insert the blocks that we need. When we're looking at that floor plan, let's come up here again. Remind me what it was. I have a 2026 window and a 3040 window. Let's start with those. So I'm going to say insert. I don't have it existing in this drawing because I haven't used that block yet. Remember, we made the blocks in another drawing. So I'm going to go to blocks from libraries. On this last tab, remember you've got, these are the blocks in my current drawing. These are the recent blocks that I've used. Here's some favorites if you want to favorite a block. But we can go to libraries. I had already navigated to this once before. But if you don't see anything here, you're going to see a button. I'm going to click the down arrow for that cabin symbols. You'll see an option to browse block libraries. The cool thing about this is you can go find wherever you saved your cabin symbols drawing. You're just going to navigate through there. Takes a little second. And there we go. So now we have, oh my gosh, I've lost it already. Let me go find the door sizes. I'm just going to pull up my drawing here. 2'026. So I'm going to find my 2'0" by 2'6". I'm going to click on that, and now it grabbed it, and I'm going to just snap it. Remember, the top of this line is to the height. That's the 6'8". So this is going to be as tall as that door is going to be outside of the trim. If you did not make this as your grip or your base point, that's fine. Just set it down somewhere and then do the move command and select the top midpoint right here as your base point. So we've got that. 2026, and then we have a 3040 window. I'm just clicking on it. I have it now. I'm just going to snap it right here. And then that door size is a 2'8" door. So there's your 2'8" door. I had actually selected the base point at the bottom on this door, so that's fine. I'll select it down here. But do you see how nice that looks? So the top of my door, the top of my windows, all line up with each other. I'd be curious. Take a look around your house and see if that's what yours looks like as well. It's not always the case. That's just a pretty standard thing that they do. So this looks great. I've got my doors, I've got my windows, everything is lined up. It's all projected perfectly straight down from the floor plan. And that is all that I needed to do at that point. So now what I'm going to do is the next video, we'll put in the fireplace. We're going to figure out where that fireplace goes.